from your weather authority, here's meteorologist Kara Thompson.
Welcome back, Concho Valley. While we had a beautiful day today, as you can see from our sky cam, plenty of blue skies, it was really hot out there and actually pretty breezy as well. And just taking a look right now here in San Angelo, 107 degrees. Definitely a scorcher out there. Dew point currently at 61 degrees. And those winds are coming from the south at 10 miles per hour. And much of the same is across the map right now in terms of temperatures. We're seeing triple digits all the way across the map. We're even at 108 in Mertzon and Sterling City, a little bit cooler down to our southeastern counties with Junction at 101. And like I said, we're going to get a little bit cooler, but we're going to still be flirting with those 100-degree temperatures as we head into the new week. And just taking a look at our almanac data for today, as you can see, our high sticking at 107 for today, not quite reaching our record temperature for this day, which is 109, but pretty close. And also those morning lows still staying pretty mild overall at 79 degrees this morning. Now, taking a quick look at our radar, because we have been talking about this chance for rain, right now it's pretty clear across the area. However, we do kind of have these storms firing off in northern Sterling County right now. So those are expected to make its way eastward. And like I've been kind of saying, we have a slight chance as we head into tonight. And that's mainly due, we have that dry line that's off to our west, basically bordering the Concho Valley right now. We kind of have this three-point system happening with this front and the other dry line as well. And we have a ton of instability out there. So all those ingredients together do make chances for severe weather as we head into the evening hours. And the Storm Prediction Center has put out a prediction of at least some marginal risk for storms as we head into the evening hours. Basically, our biggest hazard is going to be damaging winds. We could also be seeing some large hail, but that is if those storms reach our area. So that is just something to keep in mind. It is a potential, not a guarantee. And speaking of what we could expect, here's just one of the models. Now, I don't totally agree with this, but like I said, it is a potential for what could be happening tonight. And as you can see, we could see some isolated strong storms move across the area as we head towards midnight tonight. However, we should be clearing out as we head into midnight and into tomorrow morning. So that's just something to keep in mind. Make sure that you have at least two ways to get updated weather data, whether it's keeping in touch with us on Facebook or even looking at the National Weather Service page. And then as we're going into another concern, are those hot temperatures going to be waking up tomorrow in the high 70s? But once again, we'll be in those triple digits, not as hot as we were today, but still going to be close to 103 degrees here in San Angelo. Now for tonight's forecast, low of 78 degrees, slight chance for those severe storms. I'm mainly thinking they're going to be sticking towards our northern counties, Sterling, Reynolds, Koch, and Coleman overall, but I'm not going to keep out the rest of the Concho Valley, so keeping us at about a 20% chance for precipitation. And for tomorrow, high of 104 degrees, hot and breezy, could be seeing gusts up to 30 miles per hour for tomorrow. And for your Weather Authority extended forecast for the rest of the week, we'll be seeing plenty of sunshine, but like I said, we're going to be flirting with those 100-degree temperature marks as we head into the new week. We'll be back after the break.